Cyclists love categorising their bikes. Whether it's road, gravel, cyclocross or hybrids, there's a boggling array of pigeonholes that a bike can fall into, and it's something that can confuse the buying process. Now, there are some key considerations that anybody looking for a new commuter should consider. These are comfort, gearing, braking, tyres and frame mounts, and in this video we'll consider which type of bike does it best. A decent bike for cycling to work will typically cost around £500, although road bikes may be more expensive and gravel bikes will definitely add more to the bill. At this price point, most bike frames are going to be the same, they'll be made of aluminium. This means there's limited room for manoeuvre in terms of the frame, so the type of handlebar usually affects comfort more, as well as tyre widths, but we'll come to that later on. Compared to the drop bars that you might find on a road or gravel bike, a flat bar is typically found on a hybrid bike, which, as the name suggests, is a sort of blend of a road bike and a mountain bike. It offers a host of benefits, the most notable of which is being able to sit in an upright and comfortable position compared to the more stretched position that a bike with a drop bar can drag you into. They'll also offer stability to the bike's handling, unlike a drop bar that can add a bit of twitchiness. A great example is the Triben RC500, which is available as both a road bike and a flat bar bike. The latter we absolutely loved when we tested it. The flat bar puts you in a comfortable position, which adds confidence and offers a superb line of sight when riding in traffic. Gearing is very important when it comes to commuting. For city riding, unless you live in San Francisco, a single ring on the front with a wide cassette on the rear would suffice nicely, as well as remove the complication of shifting your front gears or the faff that can come with a broken front derailleur. Many hybrid bikes feature these types of drivetrains, such as the specialised Cirrus X 2.0. However, live somewhere hillier or if you fancy taking a spin further afield, then you might want a bike with a double or a triple ring up front. Typically, when we're talking about gears, the smaller the numbers on the chainrings, the easier they are to spin. Something like the Giant Escape 1 disc, which uses a 4630 chain set and a wide 11-36 cassette, will make it easy to winch yourself up and over even the steepest climbs. Gravel bikes are also often equipped with these types of gears because of the difficulty of climbing hills off-road. However, road bikes, and some hybrid bikes, usually come with either a compact 5034 chainset or a semi-compact 5236 chainset. These are going to be harder work to pedal than a smaller chainset, but will make the bike more efficient over long journeys. Disc brakes have taken the cycling world by storm, and it's very common to find them on all hybrid and gravel bikes, and they offer more powerful and reliable braking. However, it's still common to find rim brakes on road bikes below £1,000. In any case, we'd highly recommend opting for the more powerful disc brakes, and if you can try and find hydraulic models over cable ones, then all the better. The difference between hydraulic and cable is that the former will have a better feel, require less maintenance in the long term, and in our experience, offer more powerful braking, although this often comes at a greater cost. Pinnacle and Specialized do well to spec hydraulic brakes on their flat bar hybrids for around £500 to £600. In our experience, you're more likely to find cable actuated disc brakes on gravel and road bikes at higher price points than you would on hybrid bikes. Tyre widths is a very important factor when considering a bike for commuting. Ideally, the wider the tyre the bike can accommodate, the better. Not only will the wider tyre offer greater grip, but its lower volume will also add more cushioning to the ride. This is particularly important on roads littered with potholes. Typically, hybrid frames and gravel bikes will comfortably fit wider tyres, whereas road bikes are often more limited in their capacity. You'll want to make sure that any bike you consider buying for commuting has mounts for mudguards on the front and rear. Many aluminium frame bikes will have this, and nearly all hybrid bikes, but you should definitely double check. These are important for fitting mudguards, and you don't want to end up soaked from any sitting water on the road. Equally, you can mount luggage racks to them, so you don't have to carry your clothes, lunch or laptop on your back all the time. As with all things in the world of cycling, what you're going to use the bike for and your circumstances are going to be important in your final decision. But in short, hybrid bikes are typically the most commonly used commuting bikes because of their comfort, ease to cycle, and the fact they offer great value for money. However, if you're looking to ride further afield or tackle some longer off-road rides alongside the daily commute, then a gravel or a road bike might be a better bet. So, there you go. We hope that has answered the question of what bike is best for commuting. But if you have any other questions or queries, please do leave them in the comments section below. If you have found this video helpful, then do subscribe to the Cycling Weekly channel.